Hi guys, this is Dinesh. Welcome you all to my YouTube channel. In this lecture, we are going to discuss all about your spherical polar coordinate system. Okay, here we will discuss the basic parameters, the definition and the ranges of r, theta and phi, which are the basic parameters. Then we will go for the general representation of vectors A. Then we will discuss about the direction of unit vectors, that is nothing but your r cap, theta cap and phi cap. Okay, then we will discuss the relation among x, y, z, which are the parameters of Cartesian coordinate systems, with the r, theta, phi, which are the parameters of spherical polar coordinate system. Then we will go for elemental length dl. Later on we will discuss volume element d tau, which is very important. And then we will see the area elements of sphere, hemisphere and octant and so on. Okay, so before discussing all these things, let's draw a diagram of Cartesian coordinate system, because in the video we will be discussing the spherical polar coordinate systems comparing with the Cartesian coordinate system. Okay, so first of all I want to say that you visualize a sphere, whatever you can think, then you will take a point on the sphere. You can think about a sphere of taking a ball, taking a discus, short foot, taking your football, volleyball, etc. You can imagine a sphere. Okay, then you choose a point on the sphere named P, whose coordinates are r, theta and phi. Okay, so this OP, that's from origin. I want to explain that a sphere is placed in such a way that the center of the sphere lies in the origin of your Cartesian coordinate system. Okay, so if you take a point P on the surface of the sphere, then this OP will represent your radius vector or radius of the sphere. Okay, and so what you can say, P lies on the surface of the sphere. So that R represents the radius of sphere. Okay, then this radius vector makes angle theta with your z axis. So as we know, this is x, this is y and this is z axis. So this radius vector R makes angle theta with z axis. So theta is the angle, we can note it, made by the radius vector with z cap direction. So this is about theta. So theta is the angle made by the radius vector with z direction. Okay, and what about phi? So as this radius vector makes angle theta with the z axis, there will be two components. Along z axis there will be your r cos theta, very simple, and along perpendicular to z axis this component will be r sin theta. Okay, there will be two component, r cos theta and r sin theta. So similarly you can draw a plane, this taking these two components, this will be similar to your r sin theta and this will be similar to your r cos theta. Okay, so this r sin theta and r cos theta components makes a plane, you can see. So this plane makes angle phi with your x axis. So phi is nothing but the angle made by the plane with the component, with the component r sin theta and r cos theta made with the x axis. So what? Phi is the angle made by the plane with the x axis. So phi is the angle made by plane. That plane is nothing but the component, that is component, what are the component? R cos theta and R sin theta component. So phi is the angle made by the plane with what? X axis. So these three are the definition of R, theta and phi. You must have to remember this three to understand the spherical polar coordinate system. Then we will go for the general representation of a vector in your spherical polar coordinate system. So before going to that, we see first the range of the spherical polar coordinates, which are r, theta and phi. So what will be the range of your r, theta and phi? So I have already discussed the cylindrical coordinate system, where I have said that the range of r is 0 to infinity, which is same as spherical polar coordinate system. Okay, so the range of r, because the radius of a sphere may be 0, may be infinite or very large. Okay, so the range of r lies between 0 to infinity. Similarly, the range of theta will be what? Theta is what? The angle made by the radius vector. The angle made by the radius vector with z axis. So this radius vector is a line. The z axis is a line. One line makes maximum angle 180 degree with another line. Okay. So the range of theta will be lies between your 0 to pi. 0 to pi. This is very important to understand. And the range of phi. What will be the range of phi? This plane makes angle phi with x axis. So what the maximum angle made by a plane with a line? The maximum angle can be made by a plane with a line is 2 pi and the minimum is 0. So the range of phi will lie between 0 to 2 pi. In other words, we can say r ranges from 0 to infinity. Theta ranges from 0 to phi, and phi ranges from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so this is important to understand and to remember also. Okay, so then we will go for general representation of a vector. So in spherical polar coordinates, similar to Cartesian coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system, the vector, the general representation of vector in spherical polar coordinate system will be your AR r cap plus A theta theta cap plus A phi phi cap. What are AR, A theta and A phi? These are the components, these are the magnitude of vector A along r cap, theta cap and phi cap directions. So AR the magnitude along r cap direction, A theta the magnitude along theta cap direction, and A phi is the magnitude of the vector A along phi cap direction. This is very simple to understand. Okay, so what are the unit vector directions? That's nothing but the r cap, theta cap and phi cap direction. Let's know something about these directions. Okay, so where it will direct. So let's see the figure again. Okay, so let's see the figure. This is r. So the direction of r cap will be along this direction. So r will increase this direction. Okay, similarly, this is theta. Theta will increase along this direction, and and up to this. Okay, so theta kya direction will be along this direction. Okay, and we have defined this plane makes angle phi. This plane makes angle phi with x cap direction. So the phi will increase along this direction. Okay, so this will be along this direction. So these are the three directions of unit vectors r cap, theta cap, and phi cap. On any point on the surface of sphere, we can show the direction of unit vectors. Okay, and I have prepared an example or an example to make you visualize the spherical system, spherical polar coordinate systems related with the Cartesian coordinate system in this way. Okay, so this is the sphere, this is the your smiling emoji, and I have made the three axes, three Cartesian axes. This is, you can say, the x axis, y axis, and z axis. And from this, you can visualize the sphere is a 3D system, and these three axes are perpendicular to each other. And you can take any point on the surface of the sphere. Okay. So these all which I have explained, you can visualize by taking this system into consideration. Okay, so this is the sphere. If you take any point, this I may be the any point on the surface of the sphere. So you can take the center, the distance from the center of the sphere to the I, the radius vector. Then this will max angle theta with this. This will be theta with the z axis. And similarly, can understand the angle phi with which makes phi with the plane with the x-axis. In this way, you can visualize of your own about the spherical polar coordinate system. Okay. So let's discuss about the relation with among the x, y, z, and r theta phi, which are very important to write or to understand, and again to memorize also. Okay. So let's see how I am writing these things. So we have gone up to this. This relation among x, y, z and r theta phi is very important. So how can we write? So let's see here again. So first of all, if we go from z, what will be z? This radius vector max angle theta, so this component is r cos theta, so z is similar to your r cos theta. Okay, so what about x and y? So this is your r sin theta component, yes or no? This r sin theta component max angle phi with the x axis, that's why this will be the component, this x, this the component of r sin theta along x direction will be what? R sin theta cos phi. Okay, and the component of r sin theta along this y cap y direction will be what? R sin theta sin phi. So from this we can write the relation among x, y, z and r theta phi as follows. You can see your x equals to your, you can get r sin theta cos phi, y equals to your r sin theta sin phi, and your z simply equals to your r cos theta. So you must have to remember these things when we will convert one coordinate system to another. This will be plays the crucial role to converting or to transfer the Cartesian coordinate system to spherical polar coordinate system. Okay, so in reverse manner we can find r theta and phi in terms of x, y and z. So from this relation, z equals to r cos theta, you can find theta equals to cos inverse z upon r. Yes, okay? So from these two, if you take square and add, if you square and add this, you will get what? R equals to your, so squaring all these three quantities. First of all, squaring all these three quantities and adding this, you will get x square plus y square plus z square. If you do this, so what will you get? R square, from this term, R square sine square theta cos square phi plus R square sine square theta sine square phi, and from these terms you will get R square cos square theta. So I'm writing this above, you will get, taking R square sine theta common, from these two terms you will get R square sine square theta common, you will get your cos square phi plus sine square phi plus the last term will R square cos square theta. From this you will get this result is 1, so that R square sine square theta plus R square cos square theta. If you take R square common, you will get sine square theta plus cos square theta, which is equal to your 1, so you get the result R square. So from this you can write your R is equal to your x square plus y square plus z square root over r to the power 1/2. So you can write R in terms of x, y and z in this format, okay? So similarly you can find 5, okay? So let's see the relation of phi with x, y and z. So if I divide y upon x, if I do y upon x, so what will I get? This y is nothing but your r sine theta sine phi, and your x is nothing but your r sine theta cos phi. So r sine theta cancelled, your sine phi upon cos phi is equal to your tan phi. So from this you can get phi is equal to your tan inverse y upon x. So these are the relation of r, theta and phi with x, y and z also, okay? So in this way you have to find out this relationship among x, y, z and r, theta and phi. So let's go for the elemental length dl. So this elemental length dl can be found out by found out from r theta phi. Suppose your r theta phi changes by r plus tr theta plus d theta and phi plus d phi, from which we can find out your dl. The displacement vector infinitesimal is displacement vector or the elemental length arch. In r cap directions, you must have remember from the figure, if this is r, this r dr will be in this form. So the r is increased by dr, so first in r cap direction this will be as dr r cap plus. In theta cap direction what will be? So the radius vector r increased by d theta, that's why you will get this as r d theta, okay? So component increase along this theta cap direction will be r d theta theta cap, okay? So similarly along phi cap direction, from the figure you have the r sine theta, r sine theta increased by the angle d phi, you will get from this direction, so you will get this as r sine theta d phi, Okay, so the increase in phi cap directions will be your r sin theta d phi phi cap. Okay, so in this way you can write the elemental length vector, or you can say the infinitesimally small displacement vector dl is equal to your dr r cap plus r d theta theta cap plus r sin theta d phi phi cap. Okay, so let's go for the elemental volume or the volume element. So the volume element for a sphere or in spherical polar coordinate system, you can write as follows. Just t tau, just multiplying these component, you will get the volume. Okay, so dr into r d theta into r sin theta d phi. Okay, so what will the result? R square sin theta dr d theta d phi. So this is nothing but the volume element of a sphere. So if you take the if you want to find out the total volume of a sphere, just you have to take the integration of d tau with proper condition of r theta and phi, so you can get the volume of a sphere. Okay, so in this way you can write the volume element or the elemental volume of a sphere in spherical polar coordinate system. It is very important to find the volume integral of any sphere or spherical cell, or we can say concentric sphere, and it is also applicable in the electromagnetic theory to find the total charge of a sphere, to find the electric field for a sphere or a concentric cell or concentric sphere or spherical cell. So in that case you must have to apply this t tau to find out these things. Okay, so this is very important as dl. So dl, d tau, these all are very important. So let's go for the area element of a sphere. So you can see in a sphere there are only one surface, which is the upper surface. Okay, so if I have a sphere, this is a 3D figure, you can draw properly in a plane board. So this is a sphere. If this has a one plane, this plane, so this plane is equal to your r is equal to your definite radius capital R. So for r is equal to r plane, just replace r is equal to r plane, you will get the area element dA as what? Dr is equal to your 0, dr is equal to your 0. So r d theta will be your capital R d theta. R d theta will be what? Your r is replaced by capital R d theta, and r sin theta d phi will be replaced as capital R sin theta d phi. That's why this will be r sin theta d phi. Along which direction? This is obviously along r cap direction. So finally you can write the area element of the sphere as r square sin theta d phi r cap. So in this way you can write the area element of a sphere. Integrating this dA, you can find out the total area of the sphere. Okay, with proper limit. If you integrate with proper limit, you will get the total area of a sphere. Okay, so if you have to find out the area element of a semisphere or hemisphere, what will you do? In hemisphere there are two planes. So in hemisphere there are two planes. So this is one plane and this is one plane. this upper part, this spherical plane and the planar plane. Okay, so this plane is your theta equals to pi by 2 plane, and this plane is equals to your r equals to capital R plane. So for these two plane you can write the area element in case of a what? In case of a hemisphere. So for r equals to r plane, this will similar to a sphere. Okay, so this will be your r square sine theta d phi r cap. And for theta equals to pi by 2 plane, what will be? The area element d phi will be just replaced by r square. This will be replaced by the dr is simply dr. Then r d theta will be replaced by r d theta is equals to your 0. As theta equals to pi by 2, the d theta will be 0. That's why r d theta is equal to 0. So this will not take plus, take part in the area element, and the finally r sine theta will be your r sine pi by 2 d phi. That will be r dr d phi phi cap. Okay, so in this way you can find out the area element for a hemisphere. So I want to give you some example to solve of your own, that you can find out the area element of an octant, which is 1 by 8th of the sphere. And you can also find out the area element for 1 by 4th of a sphere. Okay, and you can also find the area element for an ice cream cone. This is very important, to find the area elements of ice cream cone. I am just giving you hint that the ice cream cone is of this format. Okay, so this is your y axis, this is your z axis, and this is your x axis. For this ice cream cone, the only change is your theta equals to your 30 degree. Okay, and your r is similar to, r is ranges from 0 to r. Your theta is 0 to 30 degree, and your phi ranges from 0 to 2 phi. So for all the plane you can calculate the area element for an ice cream cone. This is nothing but your ice cream cone. So this is the end of the lecture. I hope this video is helpful for you. So please like the video, share the video with your friends, and never forget to subscribe the channel. And if you have any doubt regarding this lecture, you can ask in comment section, and you can give your suggestion in your comment section. So thank you so much for watching the video. Thank you.